Assalamu alaikum guys, what is up? This is Sanur, aka We Are Blessed. For today's video, man, is something so beautiful, man. I was looking at this, man. I looked at it. I had to clean my eyes a bit. I was like, well, I believe it. You know what, guys? You know what happened, man? Do you know what the hell what happened? Okay, I'll let you know what happened. My bad. So basically, Floyd Mayweather, you know, he's on vacation. He chilling. He doing his thing. He living that lavish life, you know, enjoying his time, doing his thing, what he does best. I mean, he box. That's what he does best. My bad. But I mean, yeah, he enjoys. He likes living good. I mean, according to him. But basically, yeah, Floyd Mayweather was in UAE, in Abu Dhabi, and out of all the places, he went to a lot of places, but out of all of them, he also chose to go to a mosque. And that is beautiful. So the mosque he visited was in Abu Dhabi, the Sheikh Zayed Grand Mosque. And we all know the beautiful reciter. That's the imam of that mosque who has this beautiful voice, and that's no other than Idris Abkar. وَإِذَا رَآكَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا إِن يَتَّخِذُونَكَ إِلَّا هُزُوًا أَهَذَا الَّذِي يَذْكُرُ آلِهَتَكُمْ وَهُمْ بِذِكْرِ الرَّحْمَنِ هُمْ كَافِرُونَ خلق الإنسان من عجل سأريكم آياتي فلا تستعجلون ويقولون متى هذا الوعد إن كنتم صادقين.
MashaAllah, he's an imam over there, and Floyd Mayweather visited that mosque. He not only went outside the mosque, he actually went inside, took his shoes off, and he did a tour, and there was a bunch of sheikhs with him. What I think why he visited that mosque was also that he wanted to also see what's Islam about. Because why would you visit a mosque? There is no reason behind going inside a mosque. You know that place, people go outside and that's it, they call it a day. But this guy went inside, meeting with the sheikhs, talking to the people of knowledge. And that you can tell that, okay, this guy was interested to go. And also going there, he wore a thobe and he wore the mashallah, the head covering, man. He looked beautiful in that, man. I'm not even joking. He looks like a boss looking all that clean. And then you can tell from the dress code too, it's like when you go for a job, you won't go with your hair all wide open, you know, go in there, hey man, I'm here. You know what, they're gonna take your resume, rip it, and kick the bloody hell out of you. The forward, stupid guy, that's what they're gonna do. That's why you need to dress well and go well. And that also shows what? That you're interested. And him dressing like that, I mean, he could have gone all day chained up, you know, my man, ripped jeans and all that, wearing a fly jacket, which he all has. But he didn't decide to do that. He decided to wear something which the Muslims wear. Him dressing like that and deciding to wear that thobe makes him show that he's serious and he actually wanted to know something. And you know what? I know what you're thinking right now. You'd be like, hey man, he's just going out there, he balling, he doing his thing. He's gonna chill, and then he's gonna, the next day he's gonna be posting pictures of that. Hey guys, I want to tell you one thing. Some of the most important figures in our history in Islam were people before they converted to Islam were haters. They hated them. Okay, I'll give you an example. Umar radiallahu anhu, the great companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who was buried beside the Prophet with Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. Umar radiallahu anhu, before Islam, he wanted to kill the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He wanted to kill the Prophet of God. Why? Because he's like, this man has came with this message and he's ruining our forefathers' religion. I can't tolerate that. I'm gonna kill him. I'm gonna volunteer. Wanted to kill the Prophet at one stage in his life. He actually ended up converting to Islam, and he ended up actually becoming one of the greatest people to ever live. And we have examples of so many. So guys, you know, judging by that story itself, we shouldn't look at the brother and be like, hey man, he ain't never gonna be straight. He gonna be crooked his whole life, man. Allah can guide him. Allah can make him so big and so knowledgeable in this religion. Allah can change his life. Allah guides whom he wills. You know, we shouldn't have that. Amen. What is there to have pride about? You know, the Jews had that pride. Allah says in the Quran, they had that pride. They were cheating. You know, some guy is doing something wrong. Hey, I won't advise him. I'll pray mine. I'll do my own thing. He can go to hell. If he's not praying, it's on him. I'm good. No advising, no giving islah, no giving no reminders, nothing like that. So guys, when we see brothers like these, it's good that we encourage this type of behavior, because you know they come from a certain lifestyle. Even when they change, it will be very hard for them to leave those certain practices which they were doing. But as the love keeps building, inshallah, from Allah's will, they will change. But guys, we need to have that incentive, and we need to be more calm about these situations rather than just typing in as a keyboard warrior and doing nothing after that and just, you know. So subhanAllah, man, I'm very happy seeing this man. He'll probably even listen to our Sheikh, you know, Idris Abkar, you know, his beautiful voice. Inshallah, hopefully he listened to that. You know, his voice, Sheikh Idris, his voice is so beautiful, man. So beautiful, man. So beautiful. SubhanAllah, man. I get dazzled by it, man. SubhanAllah, it's beautiful. So guys, if you like the video, man, like, share, subscribe. And remember, man, you blood, I blood, and we all blessed. Hopefully, man, we straighten up.